day, everybody. Welcome back to It's a Small Vlog. Today I'm here at EPCOT, and I have somebody new I'd like to introduce to the channel. This is my cousin Ryan. He doesn't come here very often. This is something I don't usually do very often. We're just spending an entire day here at EPCOT from park open to park closed. It's not a construction update, it's not a festival video, it's just a day here at the park, which is something I don't usually do very often, being an annual pass holder, which might shock some people, but we have a lot to do today. My cousin hasn't been here in, what, 2 years or something? So what are you most excited about today, Ryan?
I'm really excited to ride Guardians. I'm also really excited to see the new Moana walkthrough.
Yes.
I'm also very excited to honestly go on things I've done before, like the land and Soarin', Ratatouille.
Yep.
I just love EPCOT, you know, I'm excited to see everything.
Yep, EPCOT is both of our favorite parks, and this park is, there's a lot of new things here that he hasn't experienced yet. Guardians, Moana.
Celebration Gardens too.
Exactly, just that whole area, new fireworks show, there's a ton of stuff. We don't really have a super set plan for the day, but we're just gonna kind of play it by ear. Current time is 8:48, so the park opens in 12 minutes. We're here at Rope Drop, in case you couldn't tell by the crowds behind me. So yeah, it's a very nice morning out, so we'll see y'all shortly. Okay, the park just opened, and I apologize if I sound very groggy because I don't usually rope drop stuff. And I've been up since 7 trying to getting a Guardians pass, which I did get. I'm gonna need to find some coffee later. So I think we're gonna go to the land first. Update, we're going through Soarin', only 15 minute wait. Test track is down, so people are flooding this ride. So we decided if we can just get this one done, then that'll be good. Then we don't have to do it for the rest of the day. Okay, we just waited a total of 11 minutes for that, and now I get to have some time with my boy Patrick. I love you. Update, we just got done with Soarin', got that knocked out of the way. We waited 11 minutes, which is awesome. And now the line says it's 45, so that's good. And now we're gonna go over to Journey of Water because Ryan has never seen that before. And I know that's gonna get crowded later because it's gonna be a hot one today. Right now it feels really nice, but later it's gonna be hot. So we're gonna head over there. Yay, we made it. Journey of Water. There we go, now you can actually see it. So these are the rain harps. It's kind of fun. Nice, this one you just stand on the little thing and you're gonna just wave to it. This is so sad. This one, the spring one, it's the best one. It's not worth it. Darn it. Oh well. Anyway, there are other ones though. Yay. I'm gonna do it too. Yay. I like that one. So you get really, really wet over here. Okay, we just got done with Journey of Water. Now we're gonna explore the middle area because you haven't seen that. What did you think of Journey of Water?
I really liked it. I thought it was very well done. It was very fun. The kids seemed like they were having a great time, which is awesome.
Yes, yes.
Really well done. It was giving like a science fair or science museum.
I know that you like that kind of stuff.
I love that interactive stuff. It's classic EPCOT, very awesome.
Yes.
And we're here by the Walt statue.
Oh, yes, we are. Would you like a photo?
Sure, let's take a photo.
Okay, we're gonna get a photo with Walt. All right, middle area, first impressions.
It's good. I feel like it might get a little hot though in Florida.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't quite beat the Fountain of Nations.
Yeah, I miss
I'm
that
I'm kind of biased because I like classic EPCOT stuff, but I think it does its job well. I can already see people sitting and having a good time.
Yeah, it's just lacks a little kineticism. Comes to life at night, though. I'll give it that.
Yes, I can't judge it right now from how it is. I feel like it will definitely be better later.
Yes, like all this stuff right here on the ground, this lights up. Also, the mint looks really nice for Flower and Garden Festival. And then I'm hoping that once Communicore Hall opens, that'll also add a little kineticism to the area as well. But, yeah. So this is new. They added these two little like merchandise stands for the festival in this little corner. I believe this is the southeast quadrant of World Celebration. Yeah, they're nice. Kind of figured they would add something over here. There's a lot of empty space. Another update, this is what Communicore Hall and Plaza looks like. They are actively working on it, and I can see the mural behind the Spaceship Earth tiles.
I see a little Dreamfinder back there as well.
Yes, I do see Dreamfinder. So hopefully this will be open. My suspicion for why Flower and Garden Festival is ending so early this year is because of this. So I'm going to assume that this is going to open alongside Food and Wine in early summer. So yeah. Ryan got a Magic Band Plus the other day and is loving it. So we've been going around to all the character statues, and Figment is like one of the best ones. Oh, I just did it again. Yay. We have made it to the World Showcase, and we got Joffrey's coffee.
And chai.
I don't know what he got, but it's so good. It is so good.
It's the berry chai latte that they have. It's like their signature drink right now.
I tried a little bit, it's fantastic. I just got a nitro cold brew. Very good. And then we got, there's two scavenger hunts going on right now.
Yes.
There's the Easter one and then the Flower and Garden one. And we're gonna do both because you get some really cool prizes.
I've done the flower one. I've never been here around Easter because I guess it's a leap year.
Yeah.
Easter comes early. So I get to do the Easter one for the first time. So I'm excited to try that.
Yeah.
We should go into the Odyssey to find the first egg.
Yeah, so that'll be fun. And then, yeah, nice thing about EPCOT, it's just very chill. So, yeah, we're just kind of just chilling around the World Showcase on this fine morning. German trains, one of the best little places to vibe at EPCOT. Okay, it wasn't obvious, we just did an entire lap around the World Showcase.
Yes.
But he did his little Easter egg thing, and then...
Yeah. Little thumper.
That's really cute, I like those. They
like
had
a little ornament.
Yeah, it's like a little ornament or keychain. They had that one, Judy Hopps, Chip and Dale, and then Mickey and Minnie. So yeah, very, very cute. So, I don't really know what we're gonna do next. It is just after 11:30, and we've already done a full lap, and it's hot. But
there's a lot to see.
There is a lot to see. And it feels really nice in the air conditioning. So keep y'all updated. We're currently on Mexican It's a Small World. It's a very good ride.
Amigos, no matter where he goes, the one, two, and three goes, we're always together.
really cute. If any of y'all watched my Flower and Garden Festival video, Ryan got the chicken and waffles.
Yes, I'm excited. It looks sticky though, so I brought extra napkins.
Yeah, it looks good. So I enjoyed it. This is something that I recommended for him. Boy, it's hot today, but look how pretty the sky is. Did you enjoy your waffle?
I did. It was very good. It wasn't too sweet. It wasn't too heavy. It was just perfect.
Yeah, it was good. And time is like almost 1 o'clock. So it was like a little breakfast item and a little lunch item, chicken and waffles. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I didn't get any. I wasn't hungry. But
plus, we have a fun reservation later. Don't want to get too full.
We do. At 2:45, we're going to Space 220, which will be good. And I've only been there once. And the one time I did that, I did a video. So you should go watch it. Anyway, but we're going to go eat there. Ryan's never been there. I've only been there once. So I'm excited to go back, and I'm excited to take him there later. So that's in, like, just under 2 hours. So, yeah, we're just going to, you know, have a bunch of time to kill. So,
yeah.
I'm under the best icon at Walt Disney World, Spaceship Earth. And now we are going in. I love this ride so much. It's a classic. So I've had something happen that never happened before. Hang on. So the seats are cushiony and there's nobody like right behind us. I don't know what car this is. It's nice though. The seats are very comfy. I'll take it. Anyway, yay, Spaceship Earth.
Like a grand and miraculous spaceship, our planet has sailed through the universe of time. And for a brief moment, we have been among its passengers. But where are we going? And what kind of future will we discover there? Surprisingly, the answers lie in our past. Since the dawn of recorded history, we've been inventing the future one step at a time. So let's travel back in time together. I'll show you how our ancestors created the world we know today. And then it will be your turn to create the world of tomorrow. 30,000 years of time travel, here we are, a truly global community, poised to shape the future of this, our spaceship Earth.
My face got cut off.
Worry about your pets while you're gone, thanks to handy household robots.
It's probably for the better.
This is terrible.
Wow. So we were able to move our boarding group a little bit earlier because our Ryan reservation is in like 50 minutes. So we're gonna do Guardians before Space 220. I'm excited. So, queue so far. What's your think?
It's very nice. It reminds me of like Test Track a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't found the Ellen's right either, so I've never really been in here.
Oh
so,
yeah.
This is completely new to me.
Yeah, it's been closed since 2017, yeah, August of 2017. Yay! Are you hoping for a specific song on this ride?
Not really. I like all of them.
So.
All
right. Yeah. I mean, me neither. I finally have all six. It took me long enough. Yeah. I'll record a little bit of the pre-show, but we'll see you before the ride. Okay, we're about to board. Are you excited?
I am. I'm very excited.
I think you're gonna have a lot of fun. So he enjoyed Tron 2 days ago. So, yay. Anyway, we'll see when we get off the ride. Just got off of it, and now we're like heading to our reservation because it's right now. And what'd you think?
I loved it. I think it was fantastic. It was like Space Mountain meets the Mummy at Universal. It was fantastic.
Oh, yeah, that's a good way to put it.
It
yeah.
was so good.
Yeah, I just, I love
little
it.
Dizzy. I got a little dizzy, but we're all good. I can see where people can be a little motion sick, but very good ride.
Yes, and then song-wise, we got One Way or Another.
Yes.
He was feeling conga.
I was.
I didn't really have a gut feeling about anything, but one way or another was good. I remember I used to get conga all the time, and I haven't gotten conga in forever now, so now I actually wouldn't mind getting it sometime soon. So anyway, we are heading to Space 220, which is literally right in front of us because our reservation is right now. And yeah, we'll see you when we're in the restaurant. All right, we are checked in. We've got right in. This is the elevate your dining. Yay. And green is Ryan's favorite color too.
It is.
So
you can see.
Yeah, it was meant to be. It has been quite a while since I've been in here. Space 220. They also changed their menu up a little bit, so I'm gonna get something different this time. Okay, our appetizers came here. Last time I came here, I got the calamari. This time I actually got the Caesar salad. And what'd you get, Ryan?
The Neptuna tartar.
The tuna, or Neptuna tartar. So, yeah, and then for entrees, we both got the pad thai, which I will record when it comes out. And this is the pad thai noodles with chicken. Yay, it looks very good. And you can also get this with either shrimp or tofu. We got the chicken. All right, we just got down to Space 220. They modified the menu a little bit. Food, very, very, very good.
Lots of food, big portions.
There's like too much. I didn't even finish. I actually have some of it in my bag right now. So it was good. What did you think? First time experience.
I thought it was pretty cool. I thought the atmosphere was pretty awesome. Mm-hmm. At first I was like, because it was like, pretty expensive. But
yeah.
You get the portions.
Yeah.
And they mean business. I mean.
Yeah, they're
And the food was
really
delicious
big.
Too.
Yeah,
of
it was
course,
good.
Of course, EPCOT. You know, you can't go wrong with food.
Yeah, here. I'd recommend lunch because lunch is cheaper.
Yeah.
I don't know, dinner, like, it's fine. So anyway, in case it weren't obvious enough, now we're at test track, and
it's very loud.
Yeah, it is. I don't know, should we single ride it? The line isn't even out the door. One moment. All right, I thought we were gonna single ride test track. We're actually just gonna walk through it. It says it's 85, but the line isn't even out the door, so I really don't think that it will be.
We're already inside.
Yeah, we are. So, I think we'll be good. Yeah. I'm designing my car. Looks pretty good. I like that. Oh wait. Yeah, looks good. This is my car. It looks decent. Power's like my main one. How about you?
Mine's terrible. I don't know what this monstrosity is.
It looks good. I love how both of our capabilities and efficiencies are at the bottom.
I know.
Anyway, moving on. We're about to go on like the best ride in this whole park, Living with the Land, and there's practically no wait. We love Living with the Land. Live, laugh, love, Living with the Land. Very front row, waited about 2 minutes. I love this ride so much.
It's a classic.
It's a classic, and yeah, I'd be very upset if they ever got rid of it. It's really good. Here we go. as per tradition for every Flower and Garden Festival, we're going into the Butterfly House.
Ready?
That's yes. So much fun. Ready? It's situated in between Living with the Land, or the Land Pavilion, and the Imagination Pavilion. This is so pretty. I love this. We got some little desserts in France. You got a raspberry macaroon?
Yep.
Nice. And then I got a creme brulee because creme brulee is... Oh God, that's beautiful. Creme brulee is amazing. Anyway. Okay. Kind of just chilling, walking around the World Showcase, and Ryan got some school bread from Norway, which I've never even had before.
I've heard really good things.
I have too.
Coconut custard, can't go wrong with this. Excited to give it a try.
Yeah, you said it sounds like a better donut. I think you described it as. I mean,
like
it does.
Boston cream donut with like coconut. Oh, sounds pretty good.
Yeah. So we're just kind of walking around, chilling. It's a beautiful evening out. It's still kind of hot, but the sun is going down. So we're going to try and do Ratatouille. We tried doing it earlier, and the line is really, really, really long. It seems to have gone down a little bit. So we're going to walk back over to France and see how that goes. So keep y'all updated. As we walk through World Showcase during Golden Hour, just kind of doing whatever, please enjoy this World Showcase compilation until the evening. So we're just walking really, really fast to find somewhere to go watch these things. Okay, Luminous just ended, and I don't know what on earth is going on, but there's like a ton of like just fog from the fireworks. Jeez, it's very hazy. Sorry for the glare in the video. Okay, we found a non-hazy spot, and park's closed, Luminous just ended. That was only my second time seeing it. The first time I saw it was when I did the video for it the night after it debuted. But what did you think of this new show? Because past four times you've been here, it's been four different fireworks shows.
Yeah. I like this one. I really do. I think I'd rank it higher than Harmonious and Epcot Forever, just because I really like what they did with the lights, with the water.
Yeah.
It kind of like took a bunch of the things that work with the other shows and kind of used them better. I also like this functionality.
Yes, the Match Band Plus. Yeah.
So that made a big difference too. But yeah, I thought it was very nice.
Yeah, I enjoy it. I would agree with the ranking. I think they learned a lot from what went wrong with Harmonious, and they really addressed that with this. Infrastructure-wise, story-wise even. It works, and I'm still content with it, and yeah, and I'm glad that you enjoyed it. I'm very happy to hear that, so
yeah.
We're gonna exit the front of the park, we'll go see World Celebration at night, maybe do some last-minute shopping, and then we're gonna call it a day. Alright, well, it's been a fun day. It's been a hot day, it's been a long day, but we did it. We had a very good time today, and we got a great view behind us. Did some last minute shopping in the Creation Shop, and the fire alarm's going off in there now. So that's interesting. I don't know. Anyway, how was your day experiencing new Epcot?
View was generous, but
yeah.
I loved Guardians, I loved Moana's. The Celebration Gardens is a nice, you know, it's open, thankfully.
It serves its purpose.
And it looks great at night, so
Yes. That's
good too. Honestly, pretty good day.
Yeah.
All things considered. You know, we went to Space 220, that was new. Again, Guardians, Moana, Luminous, that was
very
cool.
Yeah, and we saved the best for last, because we've been here for a week, basically. We saved Epcot for last, because it's both our favorite parks. Also, I'm tired, but like Epcot's just chill, you know, like a lot of our day actually was just kind of just walking around the World Showcase, just kind of doing whatever, you know, which is nice. That's going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed, like, subscribe, turn those notifications on, comment down below. I don't even know what you guys should comment. Just comment if you enjoyed.
Talk about if you like new Epcot, what
are
you excited about, what you want to see.
Yeah, what he said, stuff like that. Yeah, again, I hope that you enjoyed this video. My name is Bobby. This is my cousin Ryan. And have a magical day, everybody. Bye.